Well, what first attracted me was the script, to be honest. I thought Jane had written a very moving and involving and scary and classy piece that had lots of thematic richness in terms of tapping into our deepest fears of our children and the loss of children and how parents respond to their fears of their children and what they do to protect them. And I thought there was a potential to make an incredibly visual and rich period film that was incredibly entertaining, but also had a heart and had some horror at the same time. I think the story does tap into very, very deep fears and very relatable notions in terms of people's fears for their children. But also, I think there's something fascinating about a ghost story, and that it's people always have that sense of, I think people are fascinated by the afterlife and the sense of what may lie beyond, whether people believe or not. I think ghosts are a very, very interesting arena to explore, and I think people also love a good scare. I thought there was a great character to take Arthur Kipps, this young guy who's lost his wife, who's got this young son, taking him on this journey where he goes to this very unnerving place, and on a psychological journey. So he ends up at this remote house where he sees the ghost of a dead woman. And I thought there was a very strong potential to really explore both the character and the world, and to make a film that was really very scary, but had really resonant chills that stayed with people. Dan is an absolute delight to work with. He's a complete gentleman. He's incredibly gracious. He deals with the world in which he lives and the incredibly well. And he's just a brilliant actor to direct. He is so focused. From a cinematic point of view, I love the fact that it's about, ghosts are about what's in the corner of the eye, what you can't quite see, what's just, if you close your eyes or if you blink, or what's just creeping into the edges of the frame. And I think as a filmmaker, that's a wonderful thing to explore, the imagination and just tucking things in the deep back of frame. I spent a lot of time just putting, are they there? Is the woman in black there? Is it something creeping out of the darkness? And Tim and I are shooting this in a very harsh, black, contrasty way. Really rich blacks, so it's just constantly peering into the darkness, and I think that's a really interesting thing to explore. Well, I want to give people a really entertaining film, a good Friday night film that has lots of scares, but I don't want to make exploitative scares. I want to make scares that really linger with people, real chills that when they walk out of the cinema, they remember and they stay with them slightly. And again, for me, for this, rather than the slasher genre, here I'm trying to make something much more ghostly, much more withheld, much more hidden, much more what's just about to jump out of the black, what's just hit. You know, if you look at a film like Paranormal Activity, why it was so brilliant was when you looked into the dark and down into that deep corridor, you didn't know what was going to come out at you. And it's that suggestion of supernatural activity is incredibly incredibly strong and taps into all our deepest fears. So I guess I want to make a film that does tap into our deepest fears, and gives people a really good ride.